So this was the first project that I know of that was very female-led. I was extremely excited to be able to work with that kind of dynamic. So we'd all grown, we'd seen each other grown over 3 years, and it was great to be able to work together again.
As someone who has, you know, been in solar for a while, being able to see females in the field that are leading the pack in terms of like best management practices, really going above and beyond. It's weird because I don't really think about it being female-led just because we're so used to working with each other. It was more about like the complementary management styles. Each of us are really good at what we're doing. The team faced a lot of challenges in our schedule being pushed right. At the very beginning of the project, it went to the right 3 weeks due to go for tortoises. You have to have a specialized person on site and remove them in a specific way. And also you can only do it at specific times of the year. We had additional schedule issues in terms of civil issues, additional scope of work, and weather. Originally, our site had a specific entrance that was on a county road, but that was more residential. To make sure that we were keeping up our public relations, we decided to instead create a wetland crossing from one portion of our site to the other. We did this during the rainy season, so it was a big struggle to make sure that we were constructing it with proper lifts, ensuring that it didn't wash out when we were having like significant rainfall events, and basically it took about 3 months instead of the originally anticipated 6 weeks just due to the rainy season.
Another major challenge that we had was labor shortages that everybody in the world is noticing and experiencing right now. And so some of it is in solar, we're growing really fast, which is a good thing. So we're taking those experienced people and we're trying to share the knowledge pool across the sites, but then also trying to locate and find skilled, you know, people that we can bring in and teach and train and show them what it is that we're doing so we can take them along with us for the future. We work 220,000 hours safe with no recordables, which is a huge accomplishment with the amount of people that we had on site. We brought an extra safety manager, we had extra safety rovers on site, as well as our superintendents and our site team did a really good job of making sure they were in the field, having the conversation with people, stopping someone and talking to them and teaching them, hey, we're gonna do it this way because of this, this, and this. And then watching them be able to take that and just run with it or make it even better, that's what's exciting for me.
We had someone in craft who was working for electrical and she was doing AC terminations. Stayed through the end of the project, helped me out with job book closeout, and then ended up interviewing for project coordinator and is now a coordinator on one of our other projects. My quality control lead on this past project, she had actually worked for me for a couple other projects. About halfway through this past project, we had a quality manager quit on a project further north. So we need someone to fill the spot, and I knew she could do it. So she interviewed, and she got the position. So she was able to move out of the project we were on and onto the next project. I absolutely missed her, but knew it was the best for her, and now she's a manager on her next project.
My favorite part of working on this project was definitely the people. We've been together for a long time. We had to work long hours, 60 to 70 hour work weeks. And when you have to spend that much time on site, you want to like who you're working around. Working on this project taught me that even if you have like a very tough project with the right people involved, you're going to be fine. You just basically have to keep a positive outlook, keep safety in mind and at the forefront.